What's going on, guys? Welcome to the video and welcome to the channel if you are new. If you are new here, this is the Ranger build, 2011 Ford Ranger Sport 4x4, 5-speed manual that has been on the channel for just over a year now. And today I'm very excited to do a full build breakdown video. I know some of you have been asking, I've seen some comments, and this is going to be the full build breakdown. We got the manufacturers of the headlights, the taillights, the whole spec size on the lift and the wheels. Everything you want to know will be in this video. So let's just get right into it with the first mod I did. Very controversial, a lot of you gave thumbs down on it, but the first mod was the $20 tinted smoked plate covers. Huge mod, and it does change the look of your truck. Don't change my mind on it, you cannot. It changes the look of your car or truck, it really does. And actually from there was the window tint. That was about $120, done locally, took about an afternoon, and I don't regret it at all. It was probably one of the best mods I've done to the truck. Window tint is a huge must in my world. It with the black paint, you can't go wrong at all. After the window tint was this tonneau cover, the Trifecta 2.0 trifold, and it has two clamps at the top by the cab that tighten up and clip to the bedsides. And then there's two clamps on the back end, and that, you know, you release it and it then folds, making it a trifold. I have a full video installing it and kind of showing you how to use it on the channel already if you're more interested. That costed $600 alone. So for a while, that was pretty much the only mods I had done, and it took about a couple months, but then I decided to do the grill lights. The Alpina position pods, they're about $25, including tax. And they have been pretty decent. These outside lights are the original ones I put on back in September, and the center one was replaced when the headlights were put in. The outer ones are starting to flicker and burn out, but they've lasted pretty long considering the price. And I like the look. It gives it a Raptor feel, and it just makes it different from other Rangers out on the road. So heading into October of last year, which is where the big mods came to the Ranger, was the Rough Country 5-inch suspension lift, costing about $2,200, if I remember correctly. There was a lot of pricing going around through my head at that time, but I believe it was around $2,200, counting installation and everything. And of course, to go with the lift, was the wheels and tires. So to begin, I have the 17x8.5-inch fuel Anza wheels. They were $1,800 for the set, and fantastic looking wheels. You don't see them every day. They're not very common, and they fit the truck perfectly. I love the beadlock look, and fantastic, well worth the price. And they are wrapped in BF Goodrich all-terrain tires. These tires in particular were $2,000 for the set, and they are 305/65/17, like I said, making it 33-inch wheels. So it was almost $4,000 in just the wheels and tires alone. And then tack on over another $2,000 in the lift kit. And then adding on all the other little things I did, like the window tint and the tonneau cover. That brings our total to $6,165. And that's not including the headlights and taillights yet. So let's get into that. So the LED DRL headlights that I recently put in back in January, fantastic headlights. They were around $400. My girlfriend bought them for me for Christmas, and well worth the price. You do not see these headlights every day, and they look fantastic. So they were $400, like I said. These headlights are made by Spec D Tuning. The shipping, I'm not sure exactly, but it was pretty fast, and they are very good quality. Thoroughly impressed with how these came out. These in particular are black housings. So you can see a trend here with the window tint and the blacked out housing headlights. I like the blacked out look. So shortly after doing the headlights, that's when I did my final set of plate lights. These are Ford quality, like Ford OEM plate light housings. And these were expensive, even on Amazon. They were almost $100 in just the housings. I believe they were $80. And you have to buy them individually. So it's about $45 to $50 for one. But you get what you pay for, and Ford quality, OEM quality, you always want to go for. And then the LED lights inside were about $10 or $12. So let's say the plate lights that are on the truck currently were about $100. And now to the most recent mod, which I love just as much as the headlights, if not more, are these LED DRL tail lights with the L bracket running light. Looks very modernized, and I've never seen it on a Ranger, and they just happened to come up on a Facebook page. and best thing I've ever done to this truck. Just like the headlights, makes it unique. You don't see it every day. And just the look in general is awesome. These taillights made by Pro Tuning Lab were about $250, again with the smoked look, because the clear look showed too much of this reverse light, because you can actually look in there and see the bulb very clearly. So the smoked look goes well with the black and kind of hides the bulb a bit more. For the grand total of the Ranger build going into 2021, and still have mods coming in 2021 in the summer, total, grand total, $6,915 in modifications over the last year and a bit. So almost the truck's entire value put back into it in modifications. That's insane. Stuff adds up so crazy, and I could put in another $6,000 like nothing. So I really hope that this video answers a lot of your guys' questions. I know a lot of you have been asking for a build breakdown, and this is pretty much as in-depth as I could get. All the specs are laid out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you're excited to see what's more to come for the Ranger. And if you are, be sure to subscribe, be sure to leave a like, and comment what videos you want to see, or if you want any more questions answered, I can make a video for you. Actually, on top of the $6,915, there is more money put into fixing and, you know, repairing parts on this truck, like the tie rod end links, and like air filter I did a year ago, and little things like that, some body damage that was done. So the total into this truck is probably well over $7,500, not including buying it in the first place. But I'm not really gonna add that because this is a build breakdown. But if you guys are more interested in the full cost of this truck, then be sure to let me know and I can definitely make a video about it. Yeah, I hope this answered a lot of your questions, but that's gonna do it. So if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe. We're building a little community here and I wanna see it grow. I wanna be able to make more videos with the Ranger, and you'd be supporting me by doing so. So be sure to leave a like down below, leave a comment as well while you're down there, and let me know any video ideas you got for me. Any questions you want answered, or any videos you just want to see the Ranger, anything you want to see me do with the Ranger, be sure to leave a comment. And you can find me on Instagram at 6speedflesh, just like my YouTube name. I'll talk to you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, and have a good rest of your day.